This question belongs to engineering mathematics subject and was asked in GATE CSE 1992. So the question states, using modus ponens or resolution to show that the following set is inconsistent. So we need to show that if all of them are true, then it is an inconsistency. So let us prove this. Such that where x and y are universally quantified variables, a is a constant and p, q, r are monadic predicates. So it is given that x and y are universally quantified variables. So we can rewrite the above statement as, for all x, qx implies px or negation of ra. And we can write the second statement as ra or negation of qa. Third one remains the same, and for fourth one we can write it for all y, negation of p of y. Okay, we can rewrite the statements like this. Now using universal instantiation, this first let us write this as 1 2 3 4. So using universal instantiation of 1, it becomes 5, like this. Q of a implies p of a or negation of r of a, which means it is valid for any instance where a is an arbitrary constant. Now similarly, this fourth becomes equals to negation of p of a using universal instantiation. Now using modus ponens on 5 and 3. So we use modus ponens on qa implies pa or negation ra, and on 3, 3 is qa. So applying modus ponens, we get the seventh statement, which is pa or negation ra. Then what we can do? We can use resolution on 7 and 2. What is 2? 2 is ra implies, 2 is ra or negation qa. So we can use resolution on this, and we can get, we have pa or negation ra, and the second one is ra or negation qa. Okay, so we get pa or negation qa. This is our 8th statement. Now using 6 and 8. So using 6 and 8. If pa or negation qa is true and negation pa is true, then it means negation qa is true. Negation qa is true. Now see, we have negation qa is true and qa is true. So both of them can't be true at the same time. So we can say it is inconsistent. So we have proved inconsistency. Now let us see second part of the question. So what the second part states? So second part says, let S be the set of all integers, and let n is greater than equal, n is greater than 1 be a fixed integer. Define for AB belongs to S a relation such that A is related to B if A minus B is a multiple of N. Show that R is an equivalence relation and find its equivalence classes for N equals to 5. So let Z be the set of integers. So we have Z be the set of integers. And a relation R is defined on Z. R is defined on the set of integers where A is related to B. What is given if A minus B is a multiple of N? So here let us do it for 5, which means A minus B is a multiple of 5, or we can write A minus B or B minus A, anything we can write, B minus A equals to 5k for some integer k. This is our definition of our relation. Okay, now let us show that R is an equivalence relation. So for equivalence relation, we need to prove three properties: reflexive, then symmetric, then transitive property. What does reflexive property mean? Reflexive property means A is related to A. So let us assume, let us prove reflexive property. Reflexive. So we have to prove A is related to A. So we can say, let us check, if we have A and B belongs to integers such that A is related to B, Then what it means? It means B minus A equals to 5K according to the definition. Now, can we say if we check if A is related to A? So what is A minus A? A minus A is 0. Can we write it as 5 into 0? Thus, it is also a multiple of 5. Thus, we can say A is related to A. Let us see for second property, symmetric property. So if A is related, it means if A is related to B, then B should be related to A. So what does A related to B means? It means A minus B is a multiple of 5. It equals to 5k. Can we take minus common? Yes, we can. So B minus A equals to 5k. Okay. So can we write it like B minus A equals to minus 5k? Yes. Can we write it as B minus A? We can take A minus B or B minus A. Let us take, be consistent with what we have taken initially. Initially we have taken B minus A. Okay. So A related to B means B minus A is a multiple of 5. Can we take minus common? Yes. Minus of A minus B equals to 5k. Can we move minus to that side? Yes. A minus B equals to minus 5k. Can we write k1 equals to minus k? So we will write A minus B equals to 5k1, which means A minus B is also a multiple of 5, which means B is related to A. So thus it satisfies the symmetric property. A related to B implies B related to A. Let us see the third property, transitive property. What does transitive property mean? Transitive property means if A is related to B and B is related to C, then it implies A is related to C. So how will we prove this? So assume we have A, B and C belonging to the set of integers such that A is related to B and B is related to C. This is given to us. Then if A is related to B, then we can write B minus A is a multiple of 5, which means 5k, and C minus B is a multiple of 5, which means 5m for some integers k and m. So we have to check whether A is related to C or not. So for A being related to C, C minus A should be a multiple of 5. So how can we write C minus A? So can we do C minus A plus B minus B? Now can we write it as C minus B minus plus B minus A plus B minus A? Yes, we can write this taking B over there. So can we write this as C minus B is 5m and B minus A is 5k. Taking 5 as common, we get 5m plus k. Thus, we can write C minus A is a multiple of 5. Let us write it as 5x, where x is m plus k. Thus, A is also related to C. Thus, it follows a transitive property. And thus, it is an equivalence relation. Now, we need to tell what are the equivalence classes for n equals to 5. Okay. We can easily observe that it is, for n equals to 5, it is nothing but it is congruence modulo 5. I will show you how. Let us assume we have A. First equivalence class is A, such that A belongs to integers, such that A mod 5 equals to 0. All the items which have a modulus, whose modulus with 5 gives 0, will come to one equivalence class. All the items A such that A belongs to Z, such that A mod 5 equals to 1 comes to second equivalence class, A mod 5 equals to 2 come to third, A mod 5 equals to 3 come to fourth, and A mod 5 equals to 4 come to the fifth equivalence class. So we have A mod 5, A mod 5, A mod 5. Because modulus can have only 5 values, 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. So A such that A belongs to Z, A such that A belongs to set of integers, A such that A belongs to set of integers. So this is our equivalence class for n equals to 5, which means the results can be broken down into 5 classes. So these are our solutions.